Jesus says to Peter that he is the rock that he will build his church home. What did Jesus mean by that? What did Jesus mean by church? It's important that we take a moment and consider just what it means to be the church. In translation, this scripture was translated from the Greek. And the Greek word that is translated church is one that you might already be familiar with. It's the word ekklesia. Ekklesia. The word from which we draw the English word ecclesiastical. It's a compound word. It's a word that's formed by putting two words together. The root word is the passive form, kalia, which means to call or to summon. And its prefix is the word ek, the preposition ek, which means out of. Thus, ekklesia is an assembly of whole out people. Think about that. It is an assembly of called out people. Translated in the scripture, when Jesus refers to the church, he is describing people that have been called out by his message and by his word. We see this word in Acts 7:38, in the vast gathering of the Jewish people who were delivered out of the bondage of Egypt and were led by Moses to the promised land. We're called the ecclesia of the wilderness. That is the assembly of people that God had called out of bondage himself. But here in the scripture, here in this scripture, is the first time that we hear the word ecclesia to describe the assembly of his redeemed followers. It's the first time that Jesus defines church. Nowhere in the Bible is the word ecclesia ever used in reference to a building. Think about that for a minute. Nowhere was it ever used in reference to a building. The church is not a building, but is rather the called out assembly of redeemed people. Those people might meet in that building, but the church is not that building. They are called out of sin and a lost condition and into eternal life in Christ. You are the rock that Christ has built his church. I am the rock that Christ has built his church. That Christ has built Christ's church. That's an important distinction, because sometimes that point gets lost. Sometimes when we are deciding who is worthy and who is not, we forget whose church this
yes.
is.
Yes. Thank
you,
Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
The scripture says that you are the one where I build my church.
Yes,
Christ was clear in his language.
Yes.
You are the called out assembly that Christ has built his church. The distinction is small, but important. But here this is why. Before you can be put in position to be used as a rock to build Christ's church on, before you can come forward to be called out to form the assembly, you have to be clear about who Christ is. The scripture today teaches us that. Jesus asked his disciples, who do people say that I am? And they said a prophet. They said Elijah. They said John the Baptist. And then Christ asked that all important question. But who do you say that I am? That question came before the proclamation that Peter was the rock. He had to be clear that Peter knew who Christ was. And Peter answered the question, who do you say that I am? And Peter said, you are the Messiah, the living God. Without a breathtaking, without a blink, without a doubt, Peter said, you are the Messiah. You gotta know, church, that you know. question comes, you got to be ready. You got to know. Jesus says to Peter, that has not been revealed to you by flesh and blood, but by God himself. Peter knew not because someone had told him. Peter knew because Peter had a relationship with God. God himself had made Peter aware of who Jesus was. So you have to take a little walk with Jesus in order to answer that question. You have to spend some time alone to answer that question. I found out that you have to step away from all of those who are eager to give you the answer and walk hand in hand with Jesus alone. There are a lot of people who are going to tell you who Jesus is. But when the question comes, the answer won't be the one that flesh and blood gave you. The scripture says you knew that because God told you so. You gotta take a little walk. It's like the words of a song you often sing. You familiar with it? It's called In the Garden. You know the words to that hymn? It says, I come to the garden alone while the dew is still on the roses. I know you know it. And the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses. And he walks with me. And he talks with me. And he tells me that I am his own. And the joy we share as we tarry here, no other has ever known. Amen?
Amen.
We sing the words of these hymns real often, but you gotta take a moment every now and then and let it permeate in your heart. You gotta take a little walk with Jesus. And all of this reminds me of the color purple. I bet you some of y'all are saying, well, that's what Sean left. The color purple. When you look at the chair, I don't know, but how many of you had the opportunity to read a book or to see a movie? It was also a Broadway play. But there's some deep theology in the color purple. The other view exists in a lot of different places. If you're open to it and looking for it, it'll find you. And in the color purple, there's a lot of conversation that Shug has with Seeley. Seeley is the main character. Seeley has been crucified. Her life has been rough. And Shug comes to be one of her, if not her best friend. And Shug has, she grew up in the church, but she left the church. She became a cabaret singer, a concert singer. And at some point, she comes back to where Seeley is. They forge this friendship. And they have a lot of conversations. They have a conversation out in the field one day, and Celia says to Shug, I think that it makes God angry when you walk through a field of purple flowers and you don't even notice. Amen. But they have a conversation as well about who God is. Celia is obviously angry. She's doubtful about whether or not God is showing up. And she's questioning the things she's been told about God. And she and Shug have a conversation, and it goes something like this. Celia is asking Shug, who do you think God is? And Celia said, God ain't a he or a she, but it. And Celia says, but what does it look like? And she answers, it don't look like nothing, she said. It ain't a